Praise the King! Welcome to Believers Central World Update. This is Christians United Broadcasting Network. Glory to God! The planet's still turning. We're still standing on it at the moment, but things are getting kind of interesting. Yesterday, if you saw the show, we had been talking about Do we have a caller? Okay. All right. We have a caller that's been trying to call in for a while before the show started. Go, throw him on there. Let's see who it is. Let's see what's going on.
Hello?
Hello, caller. Can you hear me?
Hi. Yes. This is Earthquake Kelly. How are you?
Oh, hi, Earthquake Kelly. We haven't got to the part where we were going to talk about you yet. Do you want to hold on?
Oh, sure. Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna talk about Sheila here first for a second.
No problem.
Great, thank you.
Okay.
You guys have.
Okay.
Just hang on the phone with her.
Okay.
I can hear Sheila.
Yeah, she's hanging up on the other line.
So you're talking to Sheila at the same time?
Yes, she was showing me how to get the correct number, so I've hung up from her now, yes.
Oh, okay. Well, if you you know how to call in now, then, right? Are you able to watch the live feed?
We're trying to get it now on our computer, trying to pull it.
Okay. Well, if you are able to get the live feed going, you wouldn't have to hold on, because it will be a little bit before I can get to you. Or if you'd like to call back, here and... about 15 minutes, something like that.
Yeah.
Or you can hang on. It's your choice.
Yeah, I just wanted to listen to the broadcast. I don't have to interject or anything. Just wanted to listen.
Oh, great. Okay. Well, go ahead and hang on then. And we're just now getting started.
Sure.
We're just about to get into the news of the day. And let's see what's going on in the world. You know, North Korea doesn't like us very much in the United States.
Yes,
do they? Okay. North Korea in a nuclear warning after UN rocket resolution. North Korea has reacted angrily to a UN resolution condemning its recent rocket launch, pledging to strengthen military and nuclear capabilities. The Security Council unanimously passed the resolution, which also expanded existing sanctions on Tuesday. North Korea, in a statement early on Wednesday, pledged to bolster its nuclear deterrent and ruled out denuclearization talks. Now, this is kind of a weird situation because they announced publicly that they're doing more rocket tests, but this time they announced that the United States was the target. So things are getting interesting out there, ladies and gentlemen. We're on the cusp of amazing events happening in the world. We expect the rapture of the believers first, and then the rest of the events are going to very likely just fall into place like dominoes after that initial event. We had talked about how, Ian, can you do something about the sound on the caller there? Can you mute the caller until I'm ready or something? I can hear him talking in my ear here. Let's go see what else is going on in the world. I don't want to linger too long on the news because I want to talk to you about Sheila. I know you guys have, really been concerned about Sheila, and many of you out there have been interested in what is going on with Sheila. She has been physically assaulted by wicked spirits, fled her home. These things followed her to every hotel she stayed in, followed her from Georgia all the way to Missouri to her brother's house. These things have been trying to hurt her, trying to drive her crazy. And I mean, this woman has been under physical assault. This is not just an emotional or mental assault. This is an actual physical assault where this thing has been trying to hurt her and kill her, and it's a very scary thing. Now, yesterday, I felt kind of protective of Sheila because this is very difficult for her. She's a brand new believer, and she's precious and wonderful, and my instinct is to protect her. And so yesterday, that's why I cut Loretta's call short there to give her number to Sheila, because I was trying to keep the show from going that direction, because I don't want her humiliated. I want to protect her. And the situation is such, we have learned, Sheila and I have learned so much through this together, that she's incredible. She's truly an incredible person, and you will love her. She has decided that she wants to come on the show with her story, and that she wants to answer all your questions and take all your, take the calls and the questions. She wants to go ahead and field this because she's very, very wonderful and kind-hearted and sweet. And what she's through thinking about herself in the situation. She's considering others who are going through the same kind of torture that she has been enduring. And also she's concerned for the tribulation saints, because she and I were talking, and I think we both kind of concluded that this may very well be just a small taste of what the tribulation saints can expect after we leave, because she's a brand new believer, but she's had all of this poured out upon her. But I have seen through this amazing, experience I've been through with her, I have seen God do some amazing things in her life. He has poured the fire upon her to where I've just been desperate to help her, and he wouldn't let me help her. And then we made a public appeal on my Facebook to thousands of prayer warriors. And we had, thousands of people were praying for her. And I know a lot of you out there have been praying for her. And God would not allow us to intervene. Even thousands of us praying, he wouldn't allow us to intervene. You know why? Because he's getting her ready to go. The scripture says in Revelation 3:18, buy of me gold tried in the fire. The true saints have no gold tried in the fire. And the believers who have been following Christ prior to the rapture, we have we have bought our gold tried in the fire as we go through our trials and tests and our daily walk with the King. But she's brand new. She's a brand new believer. And she did have dabbling in the occult in her past, and so she's really been struggling with this thing that wants to hurt her. And so anyway, to kind of sum it up for you a little bit, Sheila and I talking on the phone, we have managed to see many amazing things come out of this situation. And the most amazing thing to me is Sheila herself. She has gone the whole gambit of the feelings that people go through when something like this happens. But she has stood strong in her faith. She loves the Lord Jesus Christ. And she has a good attitude, okay? She thanked the Lord for the situation. She's not afraid anymore, and she is wanting to tell the world her story and answer all of your questions in an effort to help those who may be going through similar circumstances as Sheila. You know, Sheila had a heck of a time finding people who would believe her. And so that's what she's worried about, you guys out there, because religious people don't believe you when you tell them you're being assaulted by a spirit. They don't believe you. They think there's something wrong with you mentally. But this woman is very, very sharp. She's beautiful. She's smart. She's just one of the most wonderful people I've ever met. She's precious. I just love her so much. And she's that little lamb that the Lord stopped me from worshiping to tend to her. So I knew that I needed to stop everything and attend to her. And it's really weird. You know, today I was in a dead sleep. And she tried to call me. And, you know, when I sleep, I turn my phone off. My ringer is off, you know. And then I call people back after I get up. Well, she called the ringer. I was in a dead sleep at the time, too. She called. The ringer wasn't on or anything. But for some reason, I heard it and answered it. Then ask my family. That never happens, okay? It never happens. When I'm out of it, I'm out of it. Because, you know, a lot of times I only get to sleep 2 or 3 hours, maybe 4 hours sometimes. And so when I'm zonked, I'm zonked. But her phone call not only woke me up, but I answered it. I'll admit to you, I did fall asleep on her about 5 minutes into the conversation, and she woke me up. She said, Lisa! Yeah, she woke me up. But then I got up and started moving around, and we started talking, and the king started giving us answers, and everything's awesome. But anyway, for those of you who have been really concerned about Sheila, she's okay. She's going to be with us today, Lord willing, and she's going to answer your questions and your comments. Now, Earthquake Kelly, this man here on the phone who has called in here at the start of the show, he was recommended by Brother Rick Perry, one of my Facebook friends, and Rick had explained that this pastor had experience with this kind of thing before. What I'd really like to do is, well, since you're here, Earthquake Kelly, are you there?
I'm here.
Okay. Can you tell us how common something like this is?
Very common.
Very common.
The enemy who messes with people on a regular basis. And yes.
So you see this a lot?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and I understand that you, you're a pastor. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, I'm a pastor. I've been a Christian since 1971. I come from the New York area, from the Haitian background. My father and father's father and people like that come from Port-au-Prince and City Soleil, Haiti. I'm an American-born Haitian. My dad practiced voodoo, and he passed me down to Papa Doc Duvalier in Haiti, and I became part of the presidential palace as a child, working out of through Brooklyn and Stamford, Connecticut. I was dedicated to his service there at Port-au-Prince, but my mother prayed and she forbid me from going to live in Haiti. Remained in America, but yet we practiced on behalf of Papa Doc through Connecticut and New York and to Brooklyn until God broke it to my mother. In 1971, I became a Christian, denounced all voodoo, all types of spells and curses, and I've been preaching the gospel since 1978 all around the world. I've been to guess about every country and continent on the planet. I'm constantly on TBN, on Daystar, and other networks. And I'll be back on TBN March 21st with Arthur Blessed talking about my testimony and the Word of God and where he brought me from.
That's wonderful. I know Arthur Blessed. He's awesome. He's great. He is really an inspiration. And I look forward to hopefully seeing you on camera sometime. I know you're only able to call in by phone today at Sheila's request. But, you know, I would be happy to have you, you know, appear on the show sometime and give your testimony if you'd like to do that. Because I really want to help these people that are going through this bullying by these wicked spirits.
Right. And that's all we are. We're just bullies. That's all
they are. They are bullies. But I mean, I must reiterate that, you know, nothing defies the king. So every time a wicked spirit is sent somewhere, the king is allowing that. And so we have to find out why and then get rid of it. Our job is to get rid of it.
Yes, ma'am.
And so I'm really happy to know that you are talking to Sheila. And I'm that's very, very encouraging. I want to get, I need to check in with the chat room, so I'm going to put you on hold here just another, if you could just hang in there with me. Can you stay for a while, sir?
Yeah, I'll have to call you from another number, because this, if you don't mind.
Yes, please do whatever you feel is necessary. We'll go ahead and continue with the news, and I'll need to check in with the chat room and things like that. And, you know, we'd love to have you visual as well if you can call in on Skype at Christians United One.
We're trying to get the Skype working now. Maybe we can get it up. My daughter's been working on it for the last 20 minutes to try to see you. But so far, it's to no avail. I'm going to call you from another number because I got you on my prayer line number, and other people are calling for prayer, so I got to release this line. But I'll call you from my private number.
That sounds great. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Lisa. Bye-bye.
God bless. Okay, let's check in with the chat room and see how everybody's doing over here in the chat room. Hey, Mark. Mark Saldana, welcome. Glory to God. There's Sherry. There's David. First Love, welcome. Oh, there's Dennis. I'm glad to see you, Dennis. It's great to see you here. There's Stacy and Julie. Glory to God. I love you guys so much. I'm so thankful to have you here. Oh, there's Melanie. I'm so glad to see you. There's Sheila. Sheila's in the chat room. There's Di-Di. Hey, good to see you. Welcome, everybody, to Believer Central World Update. We're going to let you guys, I know you guys, there's been a tremendous interest on Facebook and here on the show as to what is going on with Sheila. We've all been wondering about her. And I like I said, I've been trying to kind of protect her and pull the attention off of her. But she has decided she wants to share with you. She wants to help those who are going through a similar situation. So Sheila, sweetheart in the chat room, God bless you, honey. I just love you so much. Oh, there's Clinna and Janine. Hi. Mwah. And she wants to help people. And like Pastor Earthquake Kelly said, this is extremely common situation out there. So if you are out there and you are tormented like Sheila is, this is your hope. This is good news for you because you're going to find out how to take care of this problem and get rid of it, okay? You're going to get some answers here finally. And remember that the shows are recorded by Christians United Broadcasting Network, and they're uploaded to my YouTube channel at Believers Central One, and you can also go to the network's main feed at christiansunited.tk. And we're just thrilled that the Lord is doing something wonderful here. And I'm really thrilled for Mr. Pastor Kelly to get involved because I hear some feedback, CBN.
Hey, Lisa?
Yes.
Lisa, this is David again. I just want to let you know when I backslid when I was 13.
Wait, David?
Yeah, David Alexander. From yesterday.
Oh, hi, David. Hey, David, can you kill the sound in the background? It's really bad feedback.
It's done.
Okay, what
I just want to let you know, I was going to write it on the chat, but it's more simpler if I just say it out loud.
Okay.
When I was 13, I kind of lost my way a little bit, and I actually went through what Sheila's going through. I was a spellcaster, and what really blew me off of not doing it was that I was 13, I spellcast, I had a girlfriend as a girlfriend, you know, and we were fond of each other, and I cast this spell. It worked. I literally rose up out of my body, floating around. It was a mind spell that you could see anything, okay? I went to her bedroom, and I described to her the next following day exactly what her bedroom looked like. Well, she broke up with me, okay? It is real.
But that would freak a girl out there, Dave.
What's that?
I said that probably would freak a girl out, wouldn't it?
No, it's not good.
For her to know that you could come and see her in her bedroom when she couldn't see you.
That's right. I had a spellcraft casting emblem and everything. I didn't sell my soul to the devil, but I'll tell you what, I should have. It was that powerful of a spell. And I'll tell you what, when I gave it up and said, Lord, I am yours again, that demon did not want to let me go. And that demon attacked me when I chose myself for Christ and to do his ministry. And that demon came at me left and right, left and right. I could literally describe you what he looked like, but I am going to give glory to God because God took it away. I literally thought I was going insane. I had an evil dream. I had this thing come at me for almost a week. And I said, Lord, I can't handle this anymore. I'm going to use the 91st Psalm against this because I talked to my sister, and she said, use the 91st Psalm. She had actually had demons in her home because of her husband that had demons. He would bring in albums, and she was a born-again Christian. It's just my family has so much curses. It's pathetic. And it's just really real. This stuff is really, really real.
Yes, it is. It is extremely real and painful and scary.
See, the thing is, God gives you a spirit of love, not of fear. And when you learn how to love in Yeshua, and you learn how, or Jesus, same person, or Melchizedek, he's the same person. He's the same he was yesterday, today, and forever. But when you start to love him and put, like I was saying yesterday, you know, putting your hand on your belly, but when you start to love him and cast off that yucky stuff and ask him to come in your life and fulfill your life, he does just that. But back to the story. It was a horrible thing.
Hey, dude, baby, shut up.
What is that, CBN?
I have no idea what that was.
Me either. We do have another call waiting, if you can kind of sum it up for me, Dave.
I will. I'm a long talker, and I apologize. But what's the truth is that Jesus can take care of anything, but a whole group of people praying for a person all at once will take care of that demon just like that. And she's, I'm praying for you, Lord be with you. And I'm warring for you, and I'll talk to you later, Lisa. I'm going back to your show.
Awesome. Thank you for calling, Dave. Nice to talk to you.
Again, later. Hey, I also need you to send me your email address or your address to me.
Our email, I can go ahead and give it to you. It's BelieversCentralWorldUpdate@Yahoo.
Okay. Look, I actually have some films to send you. So if you could take down this number right now, you can send me your address and stuff, and I want to send some videos to you about what's going on. Take it. It's helpme, 5679@yahoo.com.
I'm sorry. Say that again.
It's helpme. Helpme.
Okay, I can't hear you. I can't hear you, Dave. Send me an email. send me an email to BelieverCentralWorldUpdate@Yahoo. Okay?
I'll put it on the chat room.
Okay, bye. Great. Okay, thank you, Dave. Wow, okay. It looks like we've got a lot of interest in what's going on now. And let's go ahead and do this. CUBN, hook us up with the other caller. Hello, caller. Can you hear me?
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, Surfquake. I'm just calling back to listen.
Oh, good. Okay, great. I wasn't sure if you were someone with a question or what, so.
No, I was just listening to you. You sounded real good.
Well, you sound good, too. Thank you. Okay, well, let's keep going with the show. And you go ahead and hang on there if you would, Pastor. I'm grateful for your time today. Now, what I'd really like to do is give you Sheila's testimony, okay?
Sure.
Sheila's testimony, if we can see that first. I think we'll go ahead and focus on that. Let me grab, let's see. Okay, it's time for us to go to our break, and I'll snag that videos for CUBN, and we'll come back and we'll hear Sheila's testimony right after this. Stay tuned.
Did we? zero, then how did things change? Seems like just yesterday we were the same. We were the same. We were the same.
Welcome to CUBN, Christians United Broadcasting Network, where we love Jesus. Amen.
Standing on the shore, 2 feet planted in the sand, soaking up your glory, yeah. Saw you walking from a distance, without a hint of resistance. You had your arms open and a warmth in your eyes. You took my hand and you whispered, of the world, right back into reality, and all that's going wrong. 'Cause in the midst of this chaotic life, I try to find peace of mind, but you've been there all along. And even now I hear you whisper,
welcome back. CUBN is our video up.
Hello, everyone, and this is me, Sheila. I'm finally where I need to be. It's been a while since my...
This is Sheila, guys. She's going to testify and take a listen, okay?
And I was talking to you guys about what happened to me with the wicked spirits and everything like that. And I finally, by the grace of God, thank you, Lord, that he put people on my path to help me out. And we figured out what it was that I wasn't doing to to solve the problem with the wicked spirits. So I'm going to talk to you guys about that. That is very, very important. It's very important, seriously. And I'm happy right now. I'm so happy. I'm at peace. You know, I'm grateful. I'm thankful for our Lord Jesus Christ and that he didn't give up on me. You know, he kept hanging in there and, you know, he was pulling for me to break through, to stand up for myself and to keep pushing, to keep learning. And pretty soon I was going to, with the help of some other individual, I was going to find what I needed to find to defeat those wicked spirits with the help of an awesome, awesome person, Lisa Dennis Sparks, that he led me to her videos months and months ago. And now I'm part of a great online true believer Christian group. And I'm very thankful and grateful to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I love him so much. And I'm very thankful for him. I'm serious. You guys, he is awesome. He is very, very awesome. He is awesome. That's my love. That's my love. But okay, I'm gonna get to the point here because I'm talking and talking and talking. Okay, you can see in the room, I'm at my brother's house. So I was in Georgia, and you know, I was left Georgia, and now I'm here in Missouri, and I've been here for a couple of days, about maybe a week or so, a little bit more than a week, maybe like, you know, not 2 whole weeks, nothing like that. I think I've been here for a little bit. And anyway, I'm happy I'm here. But listen, let me tell you what happened. Okay, you guys know the wicked spirits were bothering me and all that. And I kept trying to do things. I had the sage and I had the olive oil and all that in the hotel. And I was saying, you know, scripture and things like that. I'm supposed to say, because God gave us, you know, God didn't give us the power, the spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. You know, so God didn't give us the spirit of fear. He gave us spirit of power and of love and of sound mind. And I read that so many times, but I attend the daily, it's once a day, videos with Lisa Dennis Sparks and with the other group of people. And we went over some information and it just clicked in me, because God, you know, when Jesus walked the earth, he gave his disciples the power to cast out demons and to heal the sick and do all these amazing things. Well, we have the power also inside us. And I just didn't understand the power that we have. And, you know, and I'm like, wait a minute, what power? How do I use it? What power? And Lisa was talking to me and saying, you know, Sheila, have courage, you know, stand up, have faith, you know, you can do it. You know, God believes in you. Jesus loves you. Jesus believes in you. You can do it. I'm like, I know this. I know they believe in me. I know they love me. I love them. How can I? I just couldn't get into my head that I already had the power in me to defeat them. But I just couldn't. I couldn't. You know, I'm thinking, oh, I'm just a human. What can I do? You know, I'm nobody. And before I get to that power thing, let me go back to the wicked spirit thing. This is what happened. I got to my brother's house, and they were still bothering me, and I'm like, I'm here. I'm safe. The Lord wanted me to leave, get out that house. And I left the house and the spirits kept bothering me from Georgia, from my house, all the way to the hotel, to the other hotel. They just kept coming, right? So finally, when I got to my brother's house, you know, they kept bothering me. You know, they come mostly at night. They would bother me, you know, they would bother me. And I called Lisa at 4 o'clock in the morning. You know, I call her. She's Lisa's awesome, you guys. You can call her up anytime, you know, day or night, and she'll answer her cell phone. And if she doesn't answer, you text her. She get back to you as soon as possible. As soon as possible. I mean, she's human. She has to sleep. But she still, I mean, she does a lot of work during night, and she's up hours and hours working on things for the Lord, for Jesus. And she is awesome. She's an awesome person. And she's an angel, you know what I mean? She's a good person. And anyway, Lisa talked to me, and she goes, I called her up, and I'm like, Lisa, they're bothering me. I don't know what to do. You know, I'm studying. I'm reading the Bible. I believe in our Lord Jesus Christ. I believe in our one and only God. I believe. I love them. I'm on the phone. You know, I'm like, I'm almost through because I'm like, I drove from Georgia to Missouri, and I'm like, what is it that I'm not doing right? I'm not being punished, so what is it I'm not doing right? What is it? And she said, okay, Sheila, because she was baffled too, and she kept on thinking. She said, okay, let me ask you this. You said you were saved. I said, yeah. She said, I can't remember the exact words, you guys, okay? So, but it went similar to this. Tell me about your saved. Tell me what happened when you got saved. Tell me what does saved mean to you? I said, well, I got baptized. That's what I said, because I went to a church and I said, I want to be baptized. I want to be saved. So they baptized me. Okay. So she's like, no, that's what you do after you get saved. I'm like, huh? She said, Sheila, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to act out loud. Like I'm talking to you guys. Ask, you know, Lord, please save me from the heart though. Cause I was crying and everything, you know, I was upset and I was crying from the heart. Lord, please save me. Please save me, Lord. Please save me. You know, please forgive me for not paying attention to you for all these years and just ignoring you and turning my back on you. And I'm so sorry, Lord. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. I believe you died on the cross for my sins, for people's sins. Please, Lord, I do believe. I believe there's one and only God that created the earth and the universe. I believe, Lord. I do believe with all my heart. Please forgive me, Lord. Please forgive me. And I renounce all these wicked things I've done in the past. And then when I said that, renounce, God started putting things in my head that I did in the past, like astrology, reading my signs, my horoscope, like Ouija board a long time ago, anything, the evil eye items, anything, you know, astrology and reading signs, that's occult. Anything occult. People don't think that it's a cult. They don't think it's bad, but it's been woven into our society to be like something normal, you know, like psychic readings. I used to have that. I used to get my palm read. I used to, psychics. I would watch TV shows or watching the show. I don't do any of that. Every time he puts something in my head, I renounce it. I renounce it I'm sorry, guys. I'm just talking so fast. I'm sorry. It's just, because I know last video I did, I said, yeah, use the sage and use olive oil. I get to that. This is what you have to do. Seriously, straight up, because I'm not being bothered anymore. For real. With the sage, I was still being bothered and harassed. But I get to this. They don't like the sage. They don't, but it doesn't get rid of them. But anyway, I did all that. You know, I asked to be saved. You had to ask from your heart. You have to mean it. You have to ask from your heart, and of course you're repenting because you're turning away from your past life. You're not gonna go back to what you were doing. You better not, because you're talking to our Lord and Savior. You better not lie to Him. You know, don't do it. You know, I'm not gonna ever think of doing something like that. No, I love my Lord and Savior. I'm not gonna do something like that. But that's what I did, you guys. I had to ask, and I never did it. When I got baptized, I don't remember saying that, asking the Lord to forgive, to save me out loud. I never did it. And I was never told by the people in the church. I'm not saying people in the church are bad. I did not say that. I'm saying I went to them because I'm looking at them for guidance. Okay. I don't know. I'm trying to, I want to be Christ-like. I want to live a good life. I want to be a good person. I want to study the Bible and get close to Jesus, get close to God. I'm looking toward people in the church who've been in church for years to guide me. And they never told me this. They never told me this. And this was very, you guys saw what happened to me. You saw what I told you guys. You saw what happened to me. That is some serious stuff. And so that's what you have to do. You have to ask from your mouth. You can't just think it, you have to say it and mean it from the heart. You have to ask for forgiveness and you have to renounce all these things you've done. You know, just renounce it. You know what you did, renounce it. You know, just renounce all these terrible things that whatever comes in, even if it's fornication, whatever comes in your mind, whatever that the Lord puts in your mind, you better renounce it. You better renounce it. You better turn away from it. Renounce it and never do it again. I don't even watch TV series that have psychics in it. I just keep turning the channel. I don't watch that much TV anyway, but I don't watch those shows anymore. I don't do anything about reading signs or astrology. I don't know that anymore. That, not me. If anybody else does it, I can't say anything. I can't stop you because I don't want to judge. Because, you know, judge not that ye be not judged. Okay? So I don't want to judge. So I'm not going to judge you. That's not right. So who am I to judge? I've done bad things. You know, let the first person without sin, you know, let the person without sin cast the first stone. I'm a sinner. So how can I cast a stone at somebody when I sin? You know, I'm just keeping it real. So just like I look rough. I look rough. I know you guys. It's been a battle, you know, and we're coming to an end. And I'm glad and I'm thankful that the Lord Jesus Christ, my love, my Savior, my everything. He's just awesome. Really, he is. And I was just going through some rough time with those wicked spirits, and it hurt me that when I told the deacon what had happened to me when I was in Georgia, he looked at me like I was crazy. And he told me that because I retired from the military and I did, you know, my 20 years, he says he feels that I'm stressed and it's all in my mind. I told him that they jump on me, that they bug me. When I was in my house, they were moving the pillow up my leg and kept bothering me. They were bumping my bed and I was going like that. They were coming through the door and I could see them. They were going flying through the house. I could see them, you know? And he looking at me like this, like, if you are a deacon, if you are somebody in a church and I'm telling you this and you don't believe me, what does that say about you and how you view the word of God? I'm not saying I'm important. I'm just saying, when Jesus was here, you guys know what he did, right? He cast out wicked spirits, cast out devils, right? So you're reading this and you say you believe he did this, but when I tell you they're bothering me, you don't believe me. People are kind of, they believe certain things in the Bible and then they take what they don't believe and they throw it to the side. You have to believe from the first page to the last page. I believe the Bible from the first page to the last page, starting in Genesis all the way to Revelation. I believe that. That's why I think people like me are considered true believers. True believers. We're Christian, but we're true believers. Okay? And not trying to say anybody is less or better or whatever. I'm just saying, when I needed help, people, I talked to Lisa about this, and she goes, and other people, and I think it was, and we were talking about this, they didn't know how to help me. I mean, they would pray with me and everything, and then the wicked spirit is still with me, you know, messing around with my leg, moving around, messing around with me, and we're standing there praying, me and the deacon. And I'm crying, trying to say things like, oh, you know, my mother died years ago. Oh, Mama, please forgive me for being upset that you died. And, you know, I'm bringing back old personal things. And he told me that I have to bring back personal things to get closure. And then I'll be okay. But the wicked spirit was still with me. He came to visit me in the hotel. We're sitting down talking. The wicked spirit is bothering my leg. And he goes, Sheila, that's not true. I said, what you mean it's not true? He goes, I prayed you up so the wicked spirit can be with you. I said, you know what? I didn't get offended, but it's almost like a little bit of me was like, how dare you just be so arrogant to think that because you held my hand and you prayed me up that they're gone. I wasn't mad at him. I understand. But the thing about this is, I figured, I'm And even my brother, I love my brother. He's a deacon and he is very, you know, proud, like, you know, like a lot of religious men are in church. They're deacons. They're very proud. They're very confident, you know, in their abilities. And that's good. But if you don't believe, if you don't believe in all the Bible, this is me. If you don't believe in from the first page to the last page, and I'm talking about everything in between. If you don't believe in it, I mean, I believe your prayers are like empty prayers. That's what I feel. I feel it like, because even when I got here and my brother prayed, we held hands and prayed, the wicked spirits bothered me every day after that, still. The same day I got here, every day, and he wouldn't believe, my brother looked at me like I was crazy. He was like, really? Okay. I mean, he was like, well, it's probably in your mind. I'm like, why do people keep telling me it's in my mind? Your mind doesn't move the pillow up your leg and push you when you're in your bed and tug on you and growl in your ear and fly across the room and come through walls and doors and stomp through the stomp. I mean, like somebody walking hard through the house, making noises and hitting stuff. That's not your mind. That's wicked spirits, people. And I think my brother and the other deacon, they're religious, and I'm not religious, okay? They love religion. I love Jesus. Yes, they love Jesus. Yes, they love Jesus. Yes, they love God. They do. But they don't believe in everything the Bible is saying. Because if they did, the prayers would work. That's why I had to sit and think one day why their prayers are not working. And if they believe that wicked spirits can bother people, see, when I say wicked spirits to my brother or to the other deacon, they were like, oh, yeah, the other deacon was like, yeah, I wrestle with wicked spirits all the time. I'm like, oh, really, you do? He goes, yeah, I have thoughts all the time, sexual thoughts. I'm like, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about thoughts of, you know, sexuality. I'm not talking about thought. I'm talking about them actually putting their hands on you and bothering you and getting inside you and turning and twisting your gut up and moving up your leg and hurting and twisting. I'm talking about stuff like that. And getting in your mind and clouding your mind to where you're trying to think. And the more you think about Jesus, the more they squeeze your mind. I'm talking about some serious physical stuff. And they're looking at me like, it got irritating at first, well, for a while. And then when my brother went one night, a couple of days ago, he went and I talked to a friend of mine from my True Believer group that Lisa Dennis Sparks has on her shows every weeknight. And so I call her name is Clinna. She's awesome. And I call her up. She's my sister Clinna, And I talked to her and she told me, you know, Sheila, go ahead and bless the house. Go ahead and just get the olive oil. Don't mess up the sage. Get the olive oil and just say a prayer through the house and just speak from your heart. Speak from your heart and put crosses, you know, on the walls, the doors, go to every room. That's what I did. I may have missed a room or two or three or whatever, but I went through the whole house putting, you know, olive oil, crosses and saying the prayers and from the Bible and just saying, you know, I have the authority over wicked spirits in this house, you know, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the blood of Jesus Christ, wicked spirits, I bind and cast you out back to the pit in the name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. You know, I kept on, you know, mixing it up, but I was saying, you know, different prayers and different scripture from the Bible. And I always put in there the blood of Jesus Christ. I cast and bind you out, send you out. Do not come back. Leave now. And I kept saying it for like, I don't know, maybe 15, 20 minutes going through the house saying it and putting crosses with olive oil on the doors and walls and things like that. And after that, they didn't bother me anymore. And I think I did that, you know, last night. And they didn't bother me anymore. And, I mean, yeah, they would try to attack you, but at least they won't. It's different. You know what I'm saying? The wicked spirits are always trying to find a way to get in to your armor, your armor of God, your whole spiritual armor of God, which you do need. If you need to look in Ephesians and look at the spiritual armor of God to, you know, protect yourself. And that's very important. But anyway, my brother got back to the house, right? And he looked, and I was in the kitchen, and he came upstairs, and he was like, he was smiling like he wanted to laugh. You know, not being mean, but he looking at me like, he's like, I think he said, you blessed the house or something, he said to me. I said, yeah. He goes, and I told him what happened with the wicked spirits, and they bothered me. He said, Sheila, that can't be true because I prayed for you, and they can't be here. They are here. They were bothering me when he was praying with me when I first got here. He goes, huh, really? What were they doing? I said, they were bothering my leg. They were coming up where my feet are because your feet are not shod, you know, with preparation. Then they try to come up through your feet. And he was looking at me like, can't remember exactly the words, but, you know, I was letting him know they was messing with my leg. So I'm going to let you guys know about the feet and being shod with the preparation of the Bible, which is reading and studying. And he looked at me like I was crazy, too. And I'm like, what is going on with these deacons, man? What is going on? Is this a macho religious thing or something? I mean, but, and I was telling him, he's like, well, I think it's in your head. In a way, you know, he was saying that. And I was like, okay, you know, I had to do it because it had to come from me, you know. And I got in my room here, and he was like, Sheila, let me let you know something. This is my brother. This is what my brother told me. I am the spiritual leader in this house. And since I'm here, there's not going to be any wicked spirits in this house while I'm here. This house was blessed by my pastor. And I can tell he was very serious when he said that. And I didn't, you know, I want to respect his authority. And I know the Lord wants me to respect my brother's authority, you know, here. And I said nicely that, look, Steve, the wicked spirits don't care who you are. They don't care if you're the Pope. They don't care if you're a prime minister. They don't care if you're the president. They don't care. They're going to be what they want to be until they're casted out. But I didn't go as far as to tell him that you have to have belief to do it. Because if you don't believe everything in the Bible, me personally, if you don't believe everything in the Bible, how can you cast them out? That's like believing some of the Bible. That's like taking the Bible here and believing this much. That's like, oh, I believe this much, and I don't believe, I don't want the rest. You can't be like that. Or you can't be like, I believe what that says right there, but I don't believe what that says because that sounds too fantastical, too fantasy. It's not, none of this is fantasy. This is all real. Every bit of it is real. Every bit of it. But that's what my brother said. So I kind of was like, he said the pastor blessed the house, and I was like, okay. And he asked, he said, well, how come we're not being bothered by the demons, the wicked spirits? I'm like, well, they don't want to bother you. They want to bother me. And he could not wrap his head around it. So I kind of left it alone. And today is a new day. It's like 8 o'clock, 8:04 right now. But I didn't mention it today at all about the other day. I just let it go, you know, because I think some people, in time, God will open their eyes in time, and they will see what I'm talking about. And this is going to lead me into the rapture. Now, I want to tell you guys, the rapture is real. People probably say, well, the rapture is real. It's not even mentioned in the Bible. Listen, the word rapture is not mentioned in the Bible, but when you read different scripture, you know, it's a rapture. When you read different scripture, and I will talk about that in my next video about what scriptures to look for that talks about the rapture. That way you guys can read it and understand it and see. It's very real. I know my video was mostly about me and dealing with wicked spirits and the sage. Yeah, they don't like sage, but really the whole thing is this. Asking the Lord to save you from your heart, you know, and all those steps I said, you know, is really, really important. And also going to Lisa Dennis Sparks, go to YouTube and type in her name, Lisa Dennis Sparks, and go to her channel and look at all her videos, all of them. I mean, take notes, attend her classes, you know, I know I put it in my other videos, so attend her shows, you know, go to Believer Central Update, Believers Central World Update, Believers Central World Update .tk. So, but I put it in my other videos, I know, but this, you guys, this is so important because I want to get the word out. The King is coming, okay? We're not going through all this, just be going through it. All these people, you know, it's other people that's being tormented or being harassed and messed with by wicked spirits. Other people. You don't hear about it on the news, you know, but it's other people. And this is it, you guys. The rapture is going to happen. It's going to happen. We don't know when. No one knows when. Only the Father knows the time. You know, only the Father knows when. Okay, no one knows when. Not the angels, not the Son, only the Father in heaven knows when. But it's gonna be soon. We don't know what day. It could be any day. So you always look for it. Okay, it could be in the next 5 minutes. I might not even finish this video. It could happen. It could be tomorrow. It could be next week. It could be next month. It could be in a couple of months from now. We just don't know. But we always know. It's so close now. So many people are coming and changing over and switching over to Christianity and getting saved and getting right with God. So you guys, just spread the word and go to Lisa Dennis Sparks' YouTube site and listen to somebody who can help teach you to study the Bible. But first thing you gotta do is ask to be saved. That's the first thing. Then next thing, you get baptized. Ask to be saved, you know, ask for forgiveness. You know, repent, you know, renounce all the wicked things from the heart. You got to be truthful now. You can't be acting fake and no canned prayers, no scripted prayers from your heart. You can use some of the scripture. I mean, well, not when you ask them to be saved, no, but it has to be from the heart. All of it needs to be from the heart. Okay. And you can always go to Lisa Dennis Sparks' videos and talk to her. And you can also send her on her Facebook, you know, you can go to Facebook and type up her name. And, you know, send her, ask her questions. You know, ask her questions. Don't be afraid to ask her questions. The rapture is coming. I will not feel right. You know, God, the Lord wants us to spread the gospel and spread the truth. You know, and the truth is the rapture is coming. The rapture is coming. It could be any day now. So the first thing you have to do is be saved. You have to be saved. You have to be saved. The first thing is not baptism. Okay? But if you do a baptism, I'm not saying it's wrong. But you need to be saved ASAP. I don't care if you go, let's say you have baptism, let's say tomorrow, you have to get baptized tomorrow. Right after you get out of there, you better just drop to your knees and ask to the Lord to save you. Do not wait and say, oh, I'm going to do it after I go to McDonald's. Oh, I'm going to do it after I go shopping. Oh, I'm going to do it after I get my hair done or something. No, you better ask to be saved now, seriously. You guys, look, the Lord loves you guys. The Lord loves all of us. He doesn't want to torture us. He doesn't want to hurt us. He doesn't want to scare us. He loves us. You know, he really loves us. And I just, you know, want you guys to wake up and look up to him. Ask him to save you. Because he wants you guys to be saved. And he wants to take all of us home to the holy city. And it's nothing. When I say rapture, you're not going to be killed. You're leaving alive. And you're coming back alive. You probably say, coming back, yeah, it's going to be like a Garden of Eden on earth. You're leaving alive and you're coming back alive. That's a rapture. See, a lot of people don't believe in rapture. They believe in resurrection where you die. Which that does happen. But the rapture, you go alive, you come back alive. Okay, you guys? Don't be afraid. Do not be afraid. You know, he wants us to help each other and spread the word out there. That people, please ask the Lord to save you. Ask him to save you. I did. When I asked him, when I said out loud, I got on my knees. And then when my knees started hurting, I sat in the chair. Period. Just ask him to save you. You can't get on your knees? Okay, get in a chair. But from your heart, ask him to save you. Pour your heart out to him. Pour your heart out to him because he loves us and he wants to save us. He doesn't want us to be left behind, because when you're left behind, you're going to be going through tribulation. And this is going to be something the world has never seen. It's going to be hell on earth. It's something we can't even, not even television, you can't even imagine. Okay? And the news is not going to tell you guys anything, the truth, that what's going on. The news is not, it's so many things out there, you guys, that's happening, that the news is owned by the dark shadow government. The media is owned. The entertainment industry is owned. And I just wish you guys see this video, just do a video of your own. Do some research of your own. Don't take my word for it. Do some research. But I why would I lie? Why would I lie? Why would I spend my time? Why would I lie? There's no reason for me to lie. I'm not getting anything out of this. I'm not getting paid or getting fame. I don't want money or fame. I don't want any of that. I want you guys to wake up and realize that our Lord and Savior loves us, and he wants us home, and he wants to protect us, and he cares about us, and he died for us. You know, and it hurts him that you guys are not, you know, paying attention to him. People want to be everything else. They want to go to any other kind of religion, even the fake ones, but they don't want to come to the true gospel, which is the Bible, the holy, true gospel, the gospel of peace. You know, you guys, please look up to our God. Drop to your knees, sit in a chair, wherever you are. Just from the heart, ask him to save you. Do those things I said, please. Ask from the heart for him to save you. Repent. Ask for his forgiveness for you not paying attention to him and just ignoring him for all these years. Come on, you guys, really, seriously. He is an awesome, awesome person. And Jesus is a person. Okay, he's not some fantasy. He's not some guy wearing a tutu or whatever, or, you know, with some wings flying around. And I know they have that Cupid thing. No, Jesus is a very, very real. God is real. This is a living gospel. The Bible, this is a living word. This is living. I use this daily. You know, I wish there was some other way I could make you guys understand. And maybe there is. I just haven't thought of it yet. That you guys really, this is extremely important. And our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome, awesome God. And he cares about us. I mean, he created the universe. He created this world. And for thousands and thousands of years, we've been the dark shadows over generations have made it to where we move further and further away from the Bible and the truth, which is Jesus Christ. They make sure we move away from it further and further, think, oh, there's not really a God. Oh, Jesus Christ, oh, he was not really a person. He didn't really exist. They're trying to make people not believe, but they can't. They can't, because guess what? I'm making this video, and other people are making videos about this, and it's the truth, and we're spreading the truth. And the truth is, Jesus Christ is the truth, and he is the way, he is the light, okay? And he loves you, and he wants to save you, so ask him to save you. He will do it. Ask him to save you. And you have people who will talk to you and support you and guide you. You will. Just ask him to save you and do the rest. Okay, so I know I made this video long, but I just had to put out the information about, you know, what happened to me. But the main information is the rapture. The rapture could be any day. So we are so close. He wants to make sure he can get as many people as he can to be saved. Just have to be patient. You know, there's two kingdoms, I learned. This world has two kingdoms in it. There's a kingdom of light, and there's a kingdom of darkness. You know, the kingdom of light, just, you know, stay in the kingdom of light. And that's what I try to do every day. I try to stay in the kingdom of light, you guys. And this is so important. A lot of people say, well, kingdom of light, kingdom of darkness. Kingdom of light is like, kingdom of light is like happiness and peace and joy and being thankful and grateful and, you know, and just being happy and loving, love and peace. The kingdom of light. Think of things like that. And stay in the kingdom of light. Just, you know, I know I shouldn't say happy thoughts, but the kingdom of darkness is like sadness and angry and bitterness and unforgiving, you know, and just mean, ugly, nasty thoughts, backstabbing. You just, that's kingdom of darkness. Stay in the kingdom of light, okay, with me. And you will find your way back to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And you will say, you know what? God is awesome. God is an awesome God. And I want you guys to just hear that good news. The rapture is real. Don't let anybody tell you that the rapture, people will tell you the rapture is, oh, we're not thinking about dying. We're thinking about living. Don't believe them. The rapture is not about dying. You go alive. Okay. You're not killed. That's the resurrection. The rapture is you go alive. You come back alive. Okay. But let me leave you guys with some awesome, awesome scripture. Like I always do. I try to anyway, you guys. I try not to forget. Okay. But I know this video is long. It's like, oh, it's really long, but I had to get this information out to you guys. And if you guys are watching this video, thank you so much for watching it. And it's really important, okay? And this is no joke, okay? So here's some scripture from Romans 8:39. From Romans 8:39. Nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So let me read that one more time. From Romans 8:39, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Okay, so nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. That, you know, even if we were to die while we're here waiting for the rapture, we're gonna go to heaven. But the point is, I want you guys to know the rapture is coming. You can leave alive, okay? That's the whole thing. You can leave alive, but if you're not prepared for the rapture, and being prepared for the rapture is what I told you, those steps being saved, those steps of being saved. If you don't do those steps, you can't go in the rapture unless God says you can, allows you. But you have to do those steps to go in the rapture. If not, you're going to be left here in a tribulation where you're going to be going through things to prove you love God, to prove you love our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Guys, go in the rapture. Why you want to stay here and possibly, you know, be hunted, go through the famine and starve, hungry all the time, and become a fugitive because you're a Christian, be chased around, you have to leave from house to house, be shaking cold outside, and you're living in the woods probably or on the street, starve to death. Then you get your head cut off. Oh, before that, you probably get tortured. So why do you want to go? And then before that, you probably get tormented by demons and wicked spirits, like I was, even worse. So why go through all that when you could go into rapture? You know, and trust me, I'm not talking about like it's something, whatever. This is serious. You know, we're trying to help save souls, save people, save souls. And I want you guys, I want us to, as a family, we're all a family, to go to the holy city, you know, and meet Jesus, meet him face to face. That would be awesome. That would be awesome. Don't you guys think? I mean, that would be awesome. To meet him face to face. And I was telling Lisa, I said, man, we're standing there and we see the Lord. I'd be so excited. I just might faint. I'd be so excited. I just might faint. But yeah, seriously, guys. Seriously. I know I made this video so long, but it's just so much information that I want to share with you guys. And I have more, but I'm making another video about things. But that's the news. That's my status so far. And I'm doing awesome. And I'm just blessed. I'm just blessed. You hear me? I'm truly, truly blessed. And I want you guys to feel the same way I do. And I hope you guys do take me seriously in this video. And wherever you are, even if you think you did it years ago and you're not, just do it again. Drop to your knees. I'm not talking about, oh, well, Lord, you know, save me and I don't know what I'm doing. No, don't come to him like that. Be respectful. That is a king. No, he's the prince of princes, the Lord of lords, the king of kings. We're dealing with a monarchy, a real monarchy, not the wannabes that, you know, wasn't, you know, or anointed by God to be monarchs on earth. I'm talking about the real, the one and only, you know. So it's, hey, I'm going to leave it like that. And I hope to hear from you guys. Just leave some remarks in the comments. I mean, I know it's a long video, but you guys, this is some serious information, and don't let other people try to talk you and tell you you're crazy for believing in the rapture and all this, and you're not, and they're going to tell you that too. They're going to tell you. They're going to look at you like you're crazy. They are. I mean, just keep your cool. Don't get angry at people, and everything is going to be fine. Everything is going to be all right. You know, look at what happened to me days ago, weeks ago. Look at my other videos. You guys saw what I went through and you heard it. And I was trying different things out. But you know, one thing I did, well, a lot of things, but I kept my faith. Even though it was rough and I was like, oh no, man, this is rough. I kept my faith. I stood, you know, I stood up and I kept my faith. You know, so I want you guys to do the same thing. Okay? And I will talk to you guys later, and God bless, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
And I love Sheila so much. She's so precious. And I'm so thankful.
She's feedback. So precious.
Ah. I'm so thankful. Okay. Sorry. I was watching the live feed along with you guys. And Sheila is so precious and wonderful. I mean, she's just such a gift in my life. And I just love her so much. You know, this is her idea. I've kind of wanted to protect her from, you know, 1,000 questions and all this. But she has decided herself that she wants to let God use her experience to help others. And I'm so proud of her because it's a huge sacrifice for her to do this, but she wants to help people. She truly, from her heart, loves the Lord Jesus Christ, and she wants to help other people who are going through these things. Is our caller still there? Is Pastor Earthquake Kelly still there? See you, Ben. Pastor Kelly, if you are listening and you could call back in, this would be a good time for you to be able to jump in. And Sheila, if you would like to call in, sweetheart, people may have questions for you. And do you guys have any questions for Sheila in the chat room? I don't see any at the moment, but I just called for for anybody who has questions. So you may not have to call in right now, Sheila, but it would be great if... okay, here comes Sheila. Can you hook us up?
Hello.
See you, Ben. Sheila, can you hear me, dear?
Yes, I can hear you.
Oh, good. Okay. Can you make sure our live audience can hear Sheila? Can you guys hear Sheila in the chat room?
Can everyone hear me okay?
Okay, I think everybody can hear you now. Oh, wait a minute. Yes? Okay. Everybody can hear you now, sweetie. Now, we had one. Let's see. Somebody. Okay, what's your question, Jennifer?
We have an echo. We have some kind of echo or something.
Do you have do you have the live feed on behind you, dear, if you could mute it?
Okay, 1 second.
Okay.
Okay, it's muted.
Okay, Sheila, we have a question from the chat room. What is the status of your spiritual attacks today? Are you still being attacked?
Yes, I'm being attacked. My attacks that I'm having now in my brother's home is not as severe and aggressive as in my house in Georgia. In Georgia, there in the South, there is a lot of voodoo going on in the South. And there was a lot of spirits in my house attacking me all at one time, and I started seeing a lot of them. It was really bad. But I'm here in my brother's house, and I'm being attacked, but it's more like the attacks is more like it tries to, it crushes my chest to where I can hardly breathe sometimes. So the attacks is dangerous now. It's more to where I would have to go to the hospital if it attacks me again. So it's not as many spirits, but the one that's attacking me is very, very, very dangerous. So, yeah, I'm trying to be careful.
Wow. So this thing, I mean, I know this, but for the benefit of our audiences, so this thing attacks you physically and, like, squeezes your chest and hurts you.
Yeah, what it's doing is, this is what I'm doing, because I'm in my Bible every day. I love the Lord. I really do. I love my Father in heaven. I love the Lord. And when I read my Bible, when I do anything with the Bible, anything, even just saying prayer, talking to Him throughout the day, anything, when I read my Bible, it moves up. I can feel it moving up my body. I can feel it moving. And it gets in my chest, and my chest becomes very heavy. And then when I continue to read the word, I just keep reading. Cause I say, I'm gonna fight you. But what it does is it squeezes my chest, and then I start feeling my chest pains really bad. And I had to call the hospital the other day, because I would not stop reading, but I had to stop reading the Bible because it started squeezing my chest so bad, I thought I was going to have a heart attack. That's how strong this spirit is.
Wow.
And this from the short things I learned about from Earthquake Kelly, he likes to be called Earthquake. I know he's a pastor, but you know, you can call him Earthquake.
Okay.
Pastor Earthquake Kelly. Anyway, I talked to him, and he already told you about some of his background a little bit. And you know, at first I didn't want to call him, because I was like, who can help me? Who can help me but God? Who can help me? And I told him, he goes, oh yeah, I know what spirit that is. That spirit is called he said something about a Pastor Noctuus. It's a night spirit. It comes mostly at night, and it kills people in their sleep. It kills people in their sleep. And
wow.
There's another spirit out there, too. It's a spirit out there that's called Incubus. That spirit holds people down and have sex with them. But the spirit that's bothering me is not Incubus, the one that has sex with you and hold you down and have sex with you. And the spirit that's bothering me is the night spirit. The night, you know, in Psalms 91, when they talk about the night terror, that's Noctuus. That's the spirit at night, the night terror that kills people in their sleep.
And that's so really weird, that's isn't it?
In my house in Georgia, I never told you guys this, Lisa, but I always had those spirits kind of around me. I kind of ignored it and thought it was just my imagination. Even when I saw an angel of light, I couldn't see his face, but that was actually the devil, a dark spirit. I would hear them whispering. In my house, they would hold me down. You know how when you're sleeping and you're trying to wake up and you're trying to move your arm, but you can't move your arms, you can't get up? The spirit was holding me down in my house in Georgia. They were holding me down. They did it several times. And they would move the pillow up my leg. They were really getting physical with me, so I had to leave. I had to leave the house.
Wow. Well, you know, we noticed early on that this thing was worse at night. And that's really interesting. I really haven't studied, you know, about all these different wicked spirits. I just tell them what to do. And this is the first one that I've ever seen that was able to defy me. And then when it was able to defy me, I didn't know what to think about that because that's never happened before. I mean, not since way back when I first started following the king, you know. But this one didn't listen to me. Now, it would leave when I would cast it out, but then it would come right back. And so we went to the Facebook wall and made a public appeal for more prayer because I'm thinking, well, I'm just not strong enough to take care of this or something. And so
Lisa, what it is what I'm learning bit by bit because I'm new to this. You know that. Everybody knows that. What's happening is the spirits, I think, that you cast away from me because when I was in the hotel and I called you, I was in dire straits. I was in desperation. They ganged up on me so bad. I was in the hallway in the hotel crying. You heard me on the phone crying to you.
I was worried.
And when you said those prayers, they fell off of me, out of me. I mean, it was like you can feel the air and feel them tumbling to the floor off of me. That was how I lost count. I lost count of how many fell off of me. I don't remember how many. But you guys don't understand. These spirits are serious business. They are real, and they are trying to hurt people.
Yes, they are. They're extremely real.
They're going to hurt people, and they're going to kill people. This is some serious stuff. This is no joke. And Lisa, thank the Lord for you, and thank you, Clina. Thank you, everybody in the chat room, for praying for me. Thank you, guys, for praying for me, all on Facebook. And I'm telling you, the spirits that come at night, but this one right here, Lisa, I think this one is a very, very strong, very strong spirit. I don't know if you came up against this one before. This one is different, Lisa. This nighttime terror, this is a different one. I don't know how we can fight it, but I'm standing. I'm standing, and I'm not giving up. But this one kills people, for real. It almost killed me the other day. It was squeezing my heart. It almost killed me. So I don't know if I'll be with you guys in the rapture. I don't know.
Yes, you will. Yes, you will. Listen, sweetheart, the rapture is a gauge of salvation. If you're saved, you're going to go. Now, the whole purpose for this is for you to buy your gold tried in the fire.
Yeah.
And for you to have treasure in heaven. And for you're coming in here right here at the last second, and he's trying to catch you up really fast. So I think that he's kind of pouring a little miracle grow, and I have seen you grow amazingly. I mean, I've been amazed, seriously, at Sheila's spiritual growth through this situation. It's like the Lord has grown her up in a week to where she understands she understands things. She's got the Holy Spirit to keep her calm and keep her with the spirit, she's actually able to record these videos for those who really are going to need help with this kind of thing. These things are real. Now, they don't bother me, but I know that they're out there because I have had to cast them out and come against them, and there's times when they don't like that much, and they grovel and scream, and you'll hear low grumbling voices, and this one girl who her boyfriend brought to me, she had she had some kind of a demon inside of her, and he was scared to death. This thing was attacking him. And when I grabbed hold of her face and got right in her face, and I asked this thing what its name was, the shape of her pupils changed from round to an hourglass shape.
Yeah.
It was really weird. But, you know, these things, it didn't attack me like it did her boyfriend. It obeyed me. And I was like, yes! You know, that was that day. I was all pumped up because this thing did exactly what I told it to. And I was extremely satisfied by that. And then the Lord tossed into my brain right there at that moment, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but that your name is written in heaven. And so... Yeah. We have to keep it in perspective when we're able to command these spirits and tell them what to do. You have to keep that in perspective. You don't want to get all on your, you know, on your high horse and feel like it's you, you know, because it's the spirit. Nothing here has anything to do with me personally. If the spirit doesn't show up, then it's lame. It'll be boring. You won't learn anything. But if he shows up, it's awesome, and we learn, and we're blessed, and he just teaches us. It's wonderful. But I was, Sheila, did you have, I know we just watched your video. Did you have anything you wanted to say to anybody that your video didn't include? Or, and I'm going to ask, too, do we have any other questions for Sheila in the chat room while we've got her here?
Yeah, please. I'm. You know what, you guys, everybody. You know, not just Lisa and Clinna, because I know Clinna shared some things with me. Lisa shared some things with me that happened. And you know what? I love you guys, Clinna and Lisa. And I love you guys in the chat room. Okay, I love every single one of you. I don't know you guys personally. You know, but it doesn't matter because we're all brothers.
We're
and
family.
Sisters. Of God, okokay, we're all children of God, and I love you guys for standing by me, and there are sometimes things get hard for me the other day, and I got a little bit snappy, you know, because I'm fighting this fight, and I don't understand, you guys, why the Lord, you know, always does what he does sometimes, okay, why am I going through this, and not everybody in the chat room is, I can't say that, I don't know, the Lord, he has his reasons, God has his reasons for picking certain people to go through certain things. And I feel he, like Lisa said, I'm going through what the tribulation saints are going through, will be going through in the future. And he wants me, I feel, to share what I'm going through and do videos with the help of Lisa and CUBN to put this information out. So when we leave, guess what? They have these videos to look at and go, okay, now I know what to do. Now I'm not alone. I got it. Great. You know, that's what I feel the Lord is doing to me so that I can experience this. If I don't experience this torment, how can I tell you or any other person what to do and what's going on? How can I? I can just be assuming things, right? I'm not assuming nothing. Clinna doesn't assume anything. What happened to her? What happened to her was horrific. What happened to Lisa is horrific in the past. So we are sharing our experiences with you guys. Even David, who called in earlier, I think he called in earlier, people are sharing their experience. You guys need to stand up. Everybody who's experiencing, who is a child of God, don't be afraid. Stop being afraid. Stand up. Do a video. Do something. Get your message out there because God wants us to save his lambs, to help save the lambs. That's what he wants. So let's do that. But if you guys
awesome.
Want to ask me any questions, please ask me any questions you want.
Well, Sherry had a question. Sheila, did you partake in the communion video with Pastor
yes,
Paul
Begley
that she posted on your wall?
The Paul Begley, I went to that site, and first I did the communion with my brother. And I did
her brother's a deacon, Sherry, but she did do the communion, you'll be glad to know.
Yes, I did a communion with my brother.
Well, Jennifer says the Holy Spirit is confirming in her spirit what you're just now saying. Melanie says to tell you she loves you. Everybody in the chat room is saying, I love Sheila. Dai says, your voice is so unbelievable, Sheila. I can tell, can hear it. They're so happy to see your face and hear your voice. And and your testimony from yourself. I'm looking through here to see if we have other questions. If you have other questions for Sheila, now is the good time to post them.
And you guys, the reason why I'm saying this about the videos, I understand, trust me, I don't look like Beyonce in my videos, okay? I don't look good, but you know what?
You're beautiful!
Whenever I get something in me, whenever the spirit says, you know what, Sheila, go ahead and do this, I do it. I'm not experienced like some people are with the Bible and knowing everything. I don't. I'm not gonna lie. I don't. But I know that I feel it. I feel somehow that the time is short. I don't know. I can't explain it. I cannot explain it.
I do too.
I feel our time is short, and that we have to get the message out there. We're not doing enough. Okay, okay, we come to the chat room and we talk and we congregate. That's great. That's great. But look, you guys, we have a bigger job than just ourselves and being in the chat room. We need to be on, because you know what did the world look at? The world looks at Facebook and YouTube a lot, right? So you could be reaching so many people through Facebook and YouTube and Twitter. Hello, people. God wants us to do that. We're here on Earth right now. Let's get it together and do that.
Don't well, Melanie.
Didn't it say in the Bible, don't worry about how you look, don't worry about the clothes, the food you eat, or what you're going to wear. Your Heavenly Father knows all those things you need. He knows about that, right? Don't
yes,
worry about that
does.
Stuff.
Well, Melanie is out. Shouting
we're
out to
we're
you.
We're here to get the word out. What did God's disciples do? What did the disciples do? They got the word out. Get the word out.
Well, Melanie is telling you that she loves you and that she admires your strength. Simone loves you. Everybody loves you. First Love says, Sheila, I love you. We will be warring for you, agreeing with the Holy Spirit for you with two or more gathered together. And everybody in the chat room is just kind of reaching out. David said, Sheila, you just hit the nail on the head.
I hope so.
Well, you know, these things are real, and people are being tormented by them, and when nobody around them will believe them, what do? They're trapped and tormented. So please, when someone... and it's really difficult for them to reveal something like this to you because of your potential reaction that you may indicate that you think they're crazy or something. You've got to believe these little lambs when they tell you they're being tormented. The Bible shows us many who were tormented by wicked spirits and how Jesus came and healed them and cured their diseases and cast these spirits out. And he commands us as well to heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, cast out wicked spirits, and bring good news, liberty to the captives. You know, what Sheila mentioned a while ago, I'll elaborate just a little bit on. I would like it if Pastor Earthquake would call back. We lost him during the video, but I would like to hear in this last 15 minutes what he has to say. If you could call back, sir, that would be great.
I can get him to call back, Lisa.
Why don't you go ahead? You go ahead and see if you can't get a hold of him and see if he can call us back. And because we're only about 15 minutes before the end of the show, and I'd really like to let him say what he wants to say here to be helpful to those who are suffering in this way. Okay, guys.
Thank you,
Sheila. I love you, sweetheart.
Okay, no problem. Bye-bye.
Bye, honey. Okay, now, isn't she just the most precious thing you ever met? I mean, she's just so sweet and so loving. And, you know, Jesus loves her desperately. I told you guys that, you know, I was worshiping and he interrupted. That's the first time he has ever stopped me from worshiping him. Ever. He's never done that. But But he did. And I was worshiping him. For those of you that you know haven't heard this yet, I was worshiping the Lord and telling him how much I love him and crying my eyes out before him like I always do. And my phone began to ring. And I don't put him on hold for anything worldly. And so I ignored it. I continued to worship him. And I thought, well, I'll call him back, you know, when I'm done here, because I don't ever want to put him on hold for anything. So I go back to worshiping him, and he stopped me. He threw a scripture into my head that just stopped me dead in my tracks. He said, "If you love me, feed my sheep." And I'm worshiping him, and I'm like, "I love you, Lord." You know, that scripture, I comprehended it. And then I was like, "I do love you. I love you, Lord." And then a second time, he said, "If you love me, feed my lamb." Singular. Feed my lamb. And my phone was still ringing. And I knew immediately that I was to answer that phone. And so I stopped my worship and I picked it up, and it was Sheila, and she was in dire straits. She was in a mess, scared to death, crying. She was nearly hysterical from the fear of this thing. Okay, do we have a caller here? Hello, caller. Is it you, Pastor Kelly?
Yes, me, Earthquake. How you doing?
Oh, great. Earthquake, welcome back. We're glad to have you. We're tickled pink that you know what to do to help Sheila. Praise the King. And can you tell us a little bit about this particular spirit that is plaguing her and give us some kind of idea what must be done to get rid of it? In that kind of a
sure,
situation.
I was talking to her. Greetings to everyone that's out there. I was talking to her earlier today about my background and what I come from, and these certain spirits, and many of them are found in the Bible, but most people, Lisa, don't know what scriptures are found at. So my job is to take them there and show them what the Bible says about these things. There's probably at least 100 different spirits named in the Bible, and they're tormenting God's people, and it's time for these bullies to stop. And one is in Psalms 91, where it says, "We should not be afraid of the terror by night." And my culture, where I come from, where I come out of a Haitian background, American-born Haitian, and my father was into voodoo and different things like that, and my mother prayed me out of it, thank God. And I've been saved, filled with the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost, since 1971. So what I do, I travel all around the world, and I help the body of Christ get set free, because we are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And so in the 91st division of Psalm, there's things that terror by night. And in voodoo and in Latin, it's called pavor nocturnus. Pavor nocturnus is a spirit that's also, like I said, known as terror by night, which chokes people in their sleep. It can hold you down. There's three ways it can try to take you out. One is to try to smother you with its oversized hands or with its wings, or literally try to throw some kind of demonic rope around your neck and choke you. So there in Kobe, Japan, about 4 or 5 years ago, there was a hotel there in Japan. The spirits were attacking mostly the men, and they killed like 20 men died. And when the police got there, they couldn't figure out how these men were choked in their sleep. So it was so much devastation by these guys dying that they tore the hotel down to the ground. So these spirits, they're going on unchallenged throughout the whole planet, except by a few of us who are saved and know how to fight them. And so we tell people what to do according to the Word of God, how to. They hate prayer. These things they hate. Before you fall asleep, they hate that you would get on the side of your bed and have a revival meeting, because they know the scriptures. They know God inhabits the praises of his people. And I teach people all over the world. I said, do not
when you find yourself under attack, just fall asleep. Get on your knees and cry out to God and praise Him and worship Him, and God comes in. He protects you when you're most vulnerable at nighttime. So this is just a few of the things we teach the body of Christ how to fight back.
Pastor Earthquake, can you hear me?
Yes, I lost you for a minute.
Yeah, I think that was probably my fault there. What I was wanting to ask you is, from what I understand from talking to Sheila, you have a lot of experience in getting rid of spirits like this. Do you know how to get rid of it for her, sir?
Oh, definitely. I started...
You do?
Yes, ma'am. I do it all over the world. There was a man called me from Austria, and he's in the entertainment business over there in Austria, and he would call me, and he said, I'm tormented at night. These things are trying to kill me and hold me down and have sex with me in my sleep and choking me, and what should I do? And I told him, I took him to the Word, like I was saying earlier, and I told him how to the Word of God and the blood of Jesus and everything like that, how to counterpunch. I used to be a heavyweight fighter, and one thing they taught us is a good counterpunch. And you got to hit these bullies and these thugs, these invisible thugs, with a good spiritual Holy Ghost counterpunch. And one thing that is to anoint your head with oil, get on the side of your bed and pray, praise God. They hate that. They know they can't get past that barrier. Oh, yes, we can get rid of them. So my friend called me back from Austria, and he said, I have been sleeping good ever since you told me what to do. And he's sleeping. He lets me know because I checked back on him. I said, how are you sleeping? He said, man, these things don't bother me anymore. Thank you so much, Earthquake, for walking me through how to get rid of these things. And it works. If it works in Austria, it works in New York. It works in St. Louis. It doesn't matter where you are. Just the blood of Jesus is still... our greatest weapon, the name of Jesus, and how you apply that. Yes, ma'am, I'm excited about helping the body of Christ.
Well, may I ask you, sir, I know that there are a lot of people out there. Our broadcast is worldwide. Mm-hmm. And so I know that there are potentially hundreds of thousands of people out there around the world in these different areas where the occult is very prevalent that are suffering and really need help to get rid of these things. Can you give us your website, your YouTube? Can you give us all of the ways that people can contact you for help with these
sure,
kind of things?
Sure, I'd be honored to. I have a website. I have a ministry number. I have books.
All of them, please. Give us all of them so people can write them down. Get your pencils ready, everybody. So those that are having problems out there can write down your information and contact you and actually get some real help for this nightmare that is these night spirits.
Yes, Lisa.
Please, feel free to just give us all your information, your contact information real quick.
Sure, I'll start out with a telephone number.
Okay.
Here in California, we're located in California. We're here in the mountains. We're about an hour, maybe 45 minutes from Hollywood in the mountains here. And my telephone number is area code 661-944-1429.
Great. Repeat. I wrote that down. I'll repeat it also before we go. What about a website, sir?
Yes. www.earthquakekellyministry. Just, you have to spell Lisa. My last name is K-E-L-L-E-Y.
Yes, sir.
Many times people can't find me because they spell it K-E-L-L-Y, but it's K-E-L-L-E-Y. Ministries.org.
Do you have any videos on YouTube that people can refer to? What's your YouTube channel, sir?
My daughter and wife sets that one up. Boy. You can Google me, and I have a lot of things, probably 100 things that movies. I have things from TBN, Sid Roth, Perry Stone, Daystar.
So people should just Google Earthquake Kelly?
K-E-L-L-E-Y, and you'll see.
K-E-L-L-E-Y, guys. Did you get that?
I would love to talk to him. I would love to talk to him, love to pray for him, to take him. I'm fully equipped. I deal with everyone on this planet that God sends me. I deal with the people on Skid Row. I deal with the rich. I deal with the poor. I deal with entertainers. I deal with politicians. I deal with their children. We help people get delivered from drugs. There are so many people suffering, and there's scriptures in the Bible that will help people, Lisa. Like Nahum 2:2 deals with a group of spirits called emptiers. These spirits come in, and they just harm you and make you feel empty. And then there's other ones called the fox spirit that Jesus talked about when he said, you tell Herod, I said, tell that fox I come to cast out demons. And that's in the book of St. Luke. There's tons of scriptures. There's another one in the book of Acts. I believe it's the 27th chapter in the 21st verse. It talks about a storm called Euroclydon by name, where there's a lot of people who seem to be blown off course in their life. And then that scripture says, into the quicksand, when Apostle Paul was going through those things. So there's so many things that's mentioned in the Bible. And my job is to help the body of Christ, to help them get delivered. I will be honored. And also, we travel, we'll fly to you, we'll help you, we'll work with a child or a senior citizen. We'll help anybody to get delivered and set free.
Glory to the King of Kings!
Hallelujah.
You know how excited that makes me to know that you can help my Sheila. I've just been so worried about her. And you know, I have no experience with this kind of thing, Pastor Earthquake. I don't have any experience with this. Now, I come against spirits and cast them out and all that, but as far as these physical manifestations, I just simply don't have, that's new territory for me. And so I'm thrilled that God has sent us an expert to help. Praise the King. Do you guys in the chat room have any questions for Pastor Earthquake while we've got him here? And also, sir, did you have anything else that you wanted to add while we're waiting on questions?
Sure. I mean, there's so many scriptures in the Bible, Lisa, that deals with deliverance. There's so many. And I'm just excited to tell the body of Christ who's ever listening around the world that even one, let me tell you one particularly, Lisa. You know that people so promiscuous and they will get involved with somebody they're not married to?
Right.
One of the most dangerous things on this planet is to get involved with someone that you're not legally married to is found in Ezekiel, the 16th chapter. And God warns the body of Christ not to do that because there are things that are called polluters, and God mentioned them by name, polluters. These polluters, there's 10 different major polluters that get inside of your bloodstream. And I'm not talking about AIDS and HIV. There's things that's even worse than that can affect you in ways that you have no idea. And God's warning the body of Christ. So when I go around the world and I take people there to Ezekiel 16 chapter, the altars are filled with people crying out to get forgiveness for this. And when they do that, God, many cases, immediately or instantly delivers them from all those maladies.
Praise the King.
There's at least 100 more. And I have books and I have tapes. And the 21st of March, I'll be back on TBN talking again. I'm starting my own network. Yes, deliverance. Healing and deliverance. There are people that all over the world can get delivered from witchcraft, voodoo, cigarettes, alcohol. Do you know that alcohol in the demonic realm is called the flower of brimstone? The reason why it's called the flower of brimstone, of course, brimstone in hell itself, but it's called the flower of brimstone because it sees, the enemy sees every family that's drinking alcohol as petals on the flower. And each one, when they die or get killed or something like that, it replaces them. It's like the old saying, she loves me, she loves me not. You take a flower and pull it off back in the day. Mm-hmm. It's the same. The enemy is trying to pull every one of those petals off of the flowers. And that's why in New York, where I come from, there's stores there called, they're called alcohol and spirits. Because those spirits get inside of there, and Solomon says in the Bible that bites like an adder, like a snake. Oh, you get me excited. I just love helping people get delivered. I just love it, Lisa.
Glory to the King of Kings. I'm thrilled to hear what you have to say, Pastor. Our show, we're down to 1 minute, so it's time for us to sign off. But I would be thrilled to have you back sometime. And give us a little more broader of a tutorial on these spirits and teach us, you know, if you would, how to reach out to others and help them if that is possible. So
I would love it. They can call
that's
me.
That's wonderful. Minister. That's great. Thank you so much for calling and being willing to help our precious Sheila. We're so thankful to you. I'm personally thrilled to meet you and to have you here. And you're welcome here anytime you'd like to call. If you follow the show and you ever see somebody, you know, struggling, we would love for you to call live and intervene if the King leads you to do so.
I'll be honored to. Yeah.
We really want to help these precious little lambs. It's just an honor to have you, sir. And I'll look forward to talking to you again soon.
One last scripture, Romans 8:31. What shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? That includes the devil and his demons.
That is right. Praise the King. Well,
amen.
Guys, in the chat room, I love you so much. I'm so thankful to see you today, and thank you for your faithfulness and your support for Sheila and all of you out there that are suffering from these kind of torments. Please give Pastor Earthquake Kelly a call. Look up his videos. He can help you. And let me give you his information again. He is in California, about 45 minutes from Hollywood. His telephone number is 661-944-1429. And I will also put his information on my Facebook wall at Lisa Dennis Sparks and Lisa Dennis-Sparks. That's the one with the hyphen. Also, you can go to www.earthquakekelly online. And also you can Google Earthquake Kelly, K-E-L-L-E-Y, and you can find videos and some other resource materials that will help you. Please feel free to reach out to this wonderful pastor who God has sent to assist us in this matter if you are experiencing these kind of problems. Because if you're experiencing those kind of problems and you're seeing this, then God is reaching out to you to give you the help that you so desperately need. So get in touch with him, and God bless all of you. We're so thankful that you tuned in today, and we will see you again tomorrow, should the Lord tarry. Here, there, or in the air. Bye, guys. Love you.